For those who ski and snowboard across the world, Alaska represents the pinnacle of the sport. A region of vast glaciated mountains covered every year with 80 to 100 feet of snow, demanding the highest level of technique, protocols, and respect.
Skied to a lot of the places people like to brag about, Alta, Snowbird, Jackson Hole. There's nowhere like the Chugach.
This is the Chugach Range that surrounds Prince William Sound. 40% of the world's separate glaciers, and we access over 2 million acres. In public terms called heli-skiing, but what we really do here is remote flight operations using all mountain protocol, terrain management, and on-the-go snow assessment, assessing mountains and guiding them from the top down.
On this first episode of Access the Goods, we're going to take you deep in the range and show you the tools and techniques used by guides to keep groups safe in the mountains. The sun rises over the mountains in Valdez, Alaska. City plow crews are out early, cleaning up the foot of snow that fell last night. World-renowned big mountain skier and mechanized ski guide Dean Cummings is on a mission with his guide team to collect weather and snow data before developing a plan for the day. Dean is the founder and owner of H2O Guides, a heli-skiing operation started in 1995 after Dean competed and won the World Extreme Skiing Championships held in Valdez. Prior to coming to Alaska, Dean was a member of the U.S. ski team, spending his days off ski mountaineering Colorado's 14,000-foot peaks. It was 1991, and with an invitation to compete in the first World Extreme Skiing Competition, Dean was soon on a plane and heading to Alaska.
It was pretty wild. Locals here, even those that didn't ski or had no part of the mountains, came up with this crazy idea to host the World Extreme Skiing Championships.
And while on a flight from Anchorage to Valdez, Dean saw the future of skiing and never looked back.
I look out the window and I've never seen so much snow and glaciation in my life. As far as the eyes could see, it was unnamed peaks, just a sea of mountains.
In the years that followed, Dean helped pioneer helicopter skiing in Alaska's glaciated terrain, developing the protocols needed to explore such amazing mountains. While still remaining as a top big mountain skier today, Dean has evolved to teach four-season outdoor safety to enthusiasts young and old at every level. Mornings for Dean and his team are spent using every resource possible to analyze weather and snow. They'll develop a forecast and talk about operations for the day.
Get on the move, get the LZ prepped, and the more time you can assess snow, the better. Let's be game on though, let's flag super big time. There's gonna be so much blowing snow. Let's stand tall on our aircraft short finals. Don't move, try to get your LZ established, your PZ established well, and then stand as tall as you can be.
After discussing the operational plan, the team moves out into the field. The ground crew heads out of town to get an eye on weather and set up the remote staging area. Back in town, guides move with their groups to the hangar, push out the helicopters, and the day is on.
I'm feeling good. Those trains are tweaking.
Yeah,
you have to just kind of rest days if we're ready.
Yeah.
All right, everyone, secure. It is important your seatbelts are tight on your hip points, so we'll keep striving to do that all day. We just help each other. It just makes things load easier and quicker and safer.
All righty.
Clear.
Thank you.
Valley skiers typically arrive in Valdez on Saturday night, and they stay for a week or even a month. They come from all around the world but share the same dream to ski the last frontier. Before they can fly, skiers and riders are taught the basic protocols and techniques they'll need to know throughout their stay.
The scenario is one guy came out on the slope, he made a ski cut, slope broke out above him, and we're pretending that the fall line goes down this way here. First thing you want to do is plug it in. That's the battery power, right. 97, it's good. Once it gets down to 50, come see us in the office.
It's backcountry 101 that everyone headed out of bounds or into heli skiing terrain needs to have a beacon, shovel, a probe, and the practical knowledge to know how to use them in a rescue.
So the method is chop, chop, and then move snow. It's super key as you get.
At the hangar, guests are taught how to respect the aircraft 100%, practicing loading and unloading the helicopter with care and efficiency.
You just want to approach the helicopter between, say, 2 o'clock and 10 o'clock. So if I'm standing at noon here, you can see why. If the pilot can see you, you can see him. General rule of thumb, if you're an arm length and a half away from the aircraft, you're in a good, safe, relative place. If you're within touching distance, you're in a pretty good place. You really could not get in the rotor system. So think of it that way. Everything I'm telling you is easy to forget. It's just like people are running around. It's like, hey, slow down a little bit. It's all right. But it feels otherwise. Your first time under the blades, you know, you're like, oh my gosh. But just slow down and relax a little bit about it. Unload easy. Don't jump from the aircraft. That's pretty tight right here. You really want to just be, get your butt to the seat, step down, and slowly release this leg's weight. You don't need to be all hasty and be like trying to get out of this helicopter. We have time. Relax. Be efficient. Only the guide will unload the basket, and not that you couldn't help, but it's easier to triple check yourself than to worry about other people.
Okay, let's work off. So he'll lift off and go get another group. Then we're on another wonderful run ourselves.
Coming up, we're high over the Chugach Range scouting condition. The operational day is underway, and Dean's team is assessing the new snow. Dean Cummings' Access the Goods is presented in part by Ortovox, sharing a connection with all who have a burning passion for winter sports beyond the boundaries. Ortovox has developed a full line of high-quality, user-friendly products to enhance the snow experience, making it safer and more fun. For more information and to shop online, head to www.ortovox.com. It's a bluebird day in the Chugach Range of Valdez, Alaska. Dean Cummings and his team of heli guides are in full operation, heading out into the mountains after a huge storm blanketed the slopes with a ton of fresh powder.
Guiding in Alaska is different than anywhere else in the world, and the reason it's different is because the amount of glaciers you have and the amount of snow that you have. It's just so remote. I mean, you're going 30 miles out into the mountains and guiding these people down descents that may never have ever had anybody ski them.
Heli ski guides have the unique advantage of getting a bird's eye view when scouting runs for hazards. Before the heli sets down on the ridge, guides are looking for good slope structure with minimal hazards for the eager guests aboard.
Now, your visual observation is your most important, of course, but then once you get out on the summit, you've got to assess this mountain from the top down.
So you see that flag and you can see the wind direction, and then also that's a good reference. You lost his eye on it, and then put the skid right next to it.
With the helicopter off to pick up another group, the first few minutes are spent buffing out the landing zone, taking in the sights, and reviewing backcountry protocol.
Good stuff, this guys.
kind of where he stops, you know, under his belly, really.
So we're in the Schwann Glacier region. This is the detention center area. That's the hourglass. This area is interesting because it's got glaciers overtaking larger glaciers. These smaller glaciers are receiving so much snow in this upper topography that they're feeding in. And if you look, you'll see like four different little glaciers overtaking, going over the top of the large glacier, which usually large glaciers move faster than the small ones. So it's just an interesting feature that these things are actually growing at this time instead of receding like most glaciers are. Just an incredible place. This will mark his high point. It gives him clean air. No, back here where he's landing, the wind gets a little bit of a lift on it. Right here, it'll give him 100% clean air. He'll know exactly what's on this ridge. So we get him landing into the wind, to the east, southeast. And we're at about 5,000 feet, so most of the stuff we ski and land here is fairly low elevation, but just huge vertical gain. There's no better place on the planet that, you know, is better to fly in, as far as you don't have to go to such high elevations. When it's clear, it's usually not a lot of wind and gust spread, which is nice compared to most mountain ranges. So everything we're gonna do, guys, will be visual verbal. If you got both, you're perfect, you're king. If you got one or the other, you're still in there, and that's an all mountain protocol. If we can stay visual and verbal, and I'll pick routes that do that, okay? The other thing is terrain management, using high points, ridges, hips, to be able to scope out concerns, be able to work from the apex into the convex, assessing snow. And then the next, of course, is just on-the-go snow assessment. It's not necessarily about just digging a snow pit in the starting zone. It's about that and all your hasty pits, all your snow tests, and working in the mountains with enough experience that you actually can identify just by the feel of the snow, by the sound of the snow, and by the texture of the snow, the center sense on reading concerns or red flags that may jump out at you.
Test the slope. Here's a good chunk.
You can only do what the mountains allow you to do. You really are following the cycles and listening to what the mountains are going to let you do or not do.
What I'll do when I get to a safe zone is I'll put two poles up. That means one person comes to me. Come in light, don't come in hot, and come in tight to me. We're literally sometimes really tight on a place. And don't move, no one else comes down until I do that again. And sometimes I'll send you a little bit earlier, so just keep an eye on me. As you're skiing, do look down at times and be like, what's he doing? If I'm pointing my hand out this way, I want you to ski the direction of my pole. And when my pole drops, you're right on line. You're perfectly on line. I'm putting you on safer snow or better snow. If I cross my poles, just stop where you're at and wait for further instruction. And if I give a wave over my shoulder, we ski together at the same time. Just don't pass me up, but we can ski wherever we want. I'll sometimes identify, hey, ski skier's left of my track or right of my track. If we're on a glacier and I ask us to have 50 feet of separation on a traverse or traveling over a glacier, maintain that 50 feet throughout. If I stop and I cross my poles, stop where you're at, and let's maintain 50 feet of separation. If I'm in a place and I just stop and I don't do anything, we're just skiing in as a group. I like it.
Coming up, we're gonna follow along as groups access the amazing mountains of the Chugach Range. Dean Cummings Access the Goods is presented in part by Aera Aviation. Their team of professionals ensure the highest level of passenger safety and satisfaction while being your ticket to take you to Alaska's most famous destinations. To support those who live in the remote stretches of Alaska, Aera provides an important air cargo link and charter service. In addition, they have a reward program for frequent flyers. Learn more at flyaera.com. Skiers and riders have traveled from around the world to materialize the dream of heli-skiing in Alaska.
Great!
Accessing the goods up in Alaska. Dream come true. Always wanted to do it, and it's coming to fruition, and it's all that's built up to be bigger and better.
In the air, guides scouted the range to find the best terrain that suits the weather and snowpack forecast, along with the ability of the group. The best runs have a good slope structure, with minimal hazards above or below the group as they descend. After a storm, it's time to take it mellow, choosing a run that allows you to safely assess snow. Moving slowly and deliberately, guides will use high points to confirm safe zones before instructing the group about the run.
See that big hump? I'm gonna jump it a little bit. But that's a nice safe zone, that's a nice place to know about. And if you want to rest, that's the best place to take a rest. Right on the very tip top. You'll see I'll come with some speed and I'll kind of jump over it. So I'll set the furthest right track and you guys ski left of my track, okay? We'll do it one at a time. Get on slope.
Moving one at a time maximizes the safety for the group, ensuring that eyes are on the person skiing, spotting their run.
Off-piste demands a little different protocol. It's like, all right, let's work as a team. Let's have safety equipment. Let's ski safe zone to safe zone. And let's watch out for what's going on in the snowpack. And so you know when you're dropping it off the top of the ridge, you really got to be careful. You got to watch and maybe cut the slope a little bit before you commit. Spot your friend as he drops in, ski one at a time, things like that.
Behind the scenes of accessing these huge mountains, the ground crew is taking care of the helicopter and backing up the guides in the field. They'll watch weather, maintain emergency safety equipment, fuel the helicopter, and log where groups are skiing in the range. And on top of each run, guides will call in their position to the ground crew before they descend.
Riding in Alaska or in the Big Mountain Arena anymore has got so many different variables. It's about your health, your conditioning, the equipment you carry, your pack, taking advantage of the technology, but also being very practical.
You guys are gonna go down. Skiers right of the debris. There's some slough. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Come down a little bit then. It's kind of a pillow right here. And I don't think I'm gonna be able to react to affect it here. effectively. What you're gonna do is, you guys can enter anywhere right here.
Go ahead.
That's gonna be slightly crusted on the right.
If you enter here, you guys just wanna work down, work down, work down.
Try to clean this and then say, okay, nothing went.
Then you'll take it. We'll regroup where it goes all the way up on that hump below that peak. I'm gonna get on slope and you guys see how it reacts.
The way this relates to skiing in the United States anymore is that the resorts have opened up really wild terrain, really technical terrain, which is great. Finally, we have that. But people are not differentiating between, say, all mountain skiing, which is off-piste in Europe, and or piste, which is groomed runs, totally controlled places. You know, let's say you get to Alta or Snowbird, you're literally skiing off-piste terrain when you take those traverses out off Baldy. So, using Alaska protocols, guiding and assessing from the top down is what it's all about. So you realize, okay, we're going on Mount Baldy, you've got a pack, a probe, a shovel, you triple check it, you have a plan based on the forecast, you go into the mountains with a pretty good handle on things, pretty much understanding what you should do and what you shouldn't do.
Dean Cummings Access the Goods is brought to you in part by Eagle Industries. The world leader in manufacturing military-grade nylon products, Eagle has now partnered with Dean Cummings to introduce a whole new line of outdoor goods. Jackets, backpacks, and more, tested and proven in Alaska's toughest conditions by Dean and his H2O HeliGuide team. Learn more about Eagle at www.eagleindustries.com.